Today we're going to talk about 6.3, which is factoring trinomials with a coefficient on the squared term that is not a 1. And then the end of it is the perfect square trinomials. I want to tell you that you have a choice between 6.3 and 6.4 method for using for any trinomial, again in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c, where a does not equal 1. When you're doing this, this is the preferred method. So as you move on in mathematics, this is usually what they're going to talk about. However, if you struggle with factoring, some of you may find 6.4 to be easier for you to follow. So no one's going to ever mark you wrong for using that technique. If you're using that technique, make sure you tell any tutors or any instructor that that's the technique that you have learned to use, because they usually won't talk about it, but they're not going to mark you wrong for it. When we're doing this, again, you always still need to start the problems the same way. Every single problem, no matter how many terms there is in the problem, you need to say, is it in the correct order, and is there a GCF? So this still remains the first step. So get in the habit of writing those down. There's also a side note that I want to go over real quick, and I want you to make sure you understand that the signs. And this is actually on a handout that is a summary handout. You'll still find this in Canvas. But it doesn't matter what technique you're using, the signs are always the same idea. So we will start off by looking at the last term. What I mean by that is ax squared plus bx plus c. So I'm talking about this term here. If the last term is positive, then both signs will match. They will match the middle term. So if this sign here is positive, then you're going to go and look and they will both match. Because to get a positive number, they has to be to multiply together. You have to have two positives or two negatives. If the last term is negative, the signs will always be opposite. So the signs will be a positive and negative. Now it doesn't tell you which spot the positive and negative goes in, but it tells you that those signs are in that form. See on here, they summarize the two different techniques right below here. Trial and error is the preferred technique, which is 6.3, and really 6.2, because 6.2 was if we had a leading coefficient of 1. I actually have had in here when I would strongly recommend trial and error, and then the other ones, it's your choice. And I just want to give you this feedback real quick. For me, I use trial and error 99% of the time, but if I look at a problem and I can't see it, I actually will use the AC method. So we're going to start off with number 1. It is in the correct order. There is not a GCF, but make sure you're checking that. And next thing we want to do is look at our signs. This is a positive 6, so we will match the signs of the inside. So both will be positive. Starting off, I automatically know it has to be a plus and a plus. Now, the next thing I would suggest with trial and error is I would look at, again, we are designing it to work for the first part of the FOIL, and we are designing it to work for the last part of the FOIL. We are then checking by multiplying out that the O and the I are correct, the inside pieces. We are designing it to work here, and we are designing it to work here. So the first question I want you to ask yourself whenever you look at these problems is one of those that I highlighted a prime number? And what I mean by that is there only one times itself that would work for factors? And in this case, there is. The number 3x squared, there is only one way. So I'm going to put that down, and I am not changing that value. For the number 6, I'm going to just kind of write down the possibilities here. And again, you don't have to write these all down. I'm just kind of trying to show you these pieces. I have a 3 times 2 or t times 3. 6 times 1 or 1 times 6. So those are my choices for factors for the number 6. What we're going to use to eliminate some of these trials is we're going to look and say, we couldn't pull a GCF out in the beginning, so I cannot get a GCF out in the middle. So I'm just going to write this down so I can show you what I mean by that. If I did this first case here, and I put a 3 and a 2 down in this order, you should be able to notice that there is a GCF in this first parentheses, and there cannot be because we said there's no GCF. I don't even have to multiply that one out. That one is not going to work because we do not have a GCF. Same idea for the number 6 and 1. If I were to put the 6 and 1 here, I have a GCF for this first parentheses. That cannot work. This breaks the GCF rule. This breaks the GCF rule. So those are crossed out. What you look at here at the trial and error is I really only have two possibilities that could work that I have to check. So I'm going to try the first one that's there. I'm going to put the 2 and the 3, which is this piece here. I have designed it to work for the first, so it's going to always be 3x squared. I have designed it to work for the last. What I am checking is the middle terms. So when I multiply these middle terms, I'm going to get a 9x and a 2x. So that gives me a positive 11x. That's what I was wanting to check. That works. So be careful here. I get people that multiply it out. So I want you to realize there's no reason to get these problems wrong on the test because you are checking it when you actually multiply it out. The answer is the factored form, 3x plus 2 times x plus 3. In your homework, you may end up with a problem that is prime. But on the test, you will never get a problem that's prime. So if you put the problem as prime, might as well go ahead and cross it off. You will always at least be able to pull out a GCF. So when we look at number 2, scan it first. No GCF, correct order. So now we look at our signs. It's a plus 5, which means we will match the middle sign. So I will have both negative because this positive means it matches the middle term. So now I'm going to again start off. I have a minus and a minus. And I'm going to again look at those. This 8x squared is not prime. But the plus 5 is prime. So I'm going to automatically go ahead and put a 5 and a 1 down. And again, I want you to realize I could have put the 5 first or I could have put the 1 first. It doesn't matter at this point. It will matter with what I put with that group. So the number 8 can be 2 times 4, 4 times 2, 8 times 1, 1 times 8. Those are my choices. And if you just kind of pick them and you don't follow a format, it sometimes works, but it's easy to miss something. So if I start off this problem and I put in this, and I'm going to try my first try, which is 2x times the 4x, I've designed it to work for the first, so that gives me 8x squared. Checking, does it work for the inner terms, so the outer and the inner. So I'm going to get a minus 10x minus 4x plus 5. Add the middle terms together. Remember, my goal right here is to make it to match this here. It doesn't match. Doesn't work. This one doesn't work. So I'm going to start over again, leaving that minus 1 and the minus 5 alone. Going to try the second choice, which is 4x and 2x. In this case, I multiply it out, get 8x squared minus 20x minus 2x plus 5. Add the middle two terms up. I get a minus 22x, which is the correct answer. So my answer here is 4x minus 1, 2x minus 5. Pause this at any time you need to. Rewind it to listen to it again. But whenever you're using trial and error, I think it's always best to start off with a prime number. Now, if there's no primes, it doesn't eliminate anything. You just have to kind of guess and check. But start off with putting a prime down if you have it. So going to number 3, no GCF. This sign is a minus, which automatically means that there has to be a positive and a negative. And again, that doesn't tell you which one is positive, which one is negative. This is where you have to play with it some. 4 is not prime, but 5 is. So again, I'm going to start off by putting down plus 1 and a minus 5. And I'm going to leave the 1 and 5 alone. I may have to change the positive negative piece. The number 4, remember, it can be 2 times 2. 4 times 1, 1 times 4. So I'm going to start off with the first choice, which is what most of you would have tried, which is 2x and 2x. This is going to give me 4x squared minus 10x plus 2x minus 5. That's 4x squared minus 8x minus 5. That one doesn't work. So now I'm going to go to my next choice, which is, again, leave the plus 1 and the minus 5. So I'm going to try the 4x and the x. So this is going to give me 4x squared minus 20x plus 1x minus 5. If I look at those middle terms right here, I can see I'm going to get a negative 19x, which doesn't work. I'm going to try my last piece, which if this doesn't work, it means I did something wrong. So I'm going to plug it in. Again, I'm going to put the minus 5 and the plus 1. I'm going to plug in the x and the 4x and FOIL this piece out. This gives me 4x squared minus 5x plus 4x minus 5. This gives me 4x squared minus x minus 5. That is what we wanted. So my answer here, be careful, I know I circled the other one, but my answer is the factored form. Now, I want to really quickly mention here, if you get this and you had gotten a plus x instead of a minus x, so I'm going to say that again. If you had gotten this problem and you FOILed out, you got a plus x instead of a minus x. If the signs are a positive and negative, it just means change your signs. You don't need to redo everything. So if you get the correct number except for the sign, it just means flip-flop the signs as long as you have a positive and a negative when you're factoring. So one more from this section right here. I'm going to go to example 4. This problem, we should notice that there is a GCF for this problem. So GCF, remember, is the first step. There is a GCF here. I should pull out a 2x squared. When I pull that out, I get a 12x squared plus 20x plus 3. In this case now, I do have a GCF that I've already pulled out. I'm going to circle that because I'm going to ignore it. But it's really important as part of your answer. 3 is a prime number, so I'm going to go ahead and put the plus 3 and the plus 1 because my signs will both be positive because it matches the middle. Choices for 12. 12 could be 3 times 4, 4 times 3, 2 times 6, 6 times 2, 1 times 12, 12 times 1. But realize because this number 3 is here, some of these are going to be eliminated. So I'm going to bring this problem over here real quick so that we can use a little bit more space to do this problem. So I'm going to rewrite it over here. And I'm going to copy the top problem over again just so you can see now I just copied over the problem so I can make sure I'm looking at it. Because remember, right now I know that there's an original piece, but my goal is to make it match that middle one of what's inside. So make sure, again, you're realizing you have that to type in your GCF. That's really important, but it's not something I'm looking at right now to check the trial and error. When I look at this, if I were to plug in the 4 and the 3, that would put a 3 in this second parentheses. That would be a GCF. If I did the 2 and the 6, it would also give me a GCF because the 6 and the 3. The 1 and the 12 would not work because the 12 would give me a GCF between the 12 and 3. So I've already eliminated 3 of the choices just by using that idea. So I'm going to try the first one. So I'm going to do 3x and 4x. FOILing this out gives me 9x plus 4x. That's 13x. Doesn't work. So I can cross that one out. So I'm going to again bring down the plus 3 and the plus 1. I'm going to go to the second choice I have here, which is the 6 and the 2. So I'm going to type 6x and 2x in. This is going to give me a 12x squared plus 18x plus 2x plus 3. That gives me the 20x, which is what I wanted. So my answer here is 2x squared times the parentheses 6x plus 1, 2x plus 3. The order of the parentheses do not matter, okay? But it does matter what your signs are. Does matter if you've got the GCF. Last two problems that we're going to do is perfect square trinomials. So there are problems that I tell you if you look at the summary sheet that I really recommend trial and error. Number one, if it's an x squared in the beginning, you can do those in your head. I want you to do those in your head. Trial and error, absolutely. The other case is if you see the first one's a perfect square and the second one's a perfect square, I really want you to guess and check. Can you use this? Yes, but I've told you a lot of you get confused, especially when we get to cubes, you start confusing the ideas. So I think it's a better idea to take these problems and go ahead and when you see the first number is a perfect square, we're going to guess and check. So when I look at this, please don't forget, GCF is still first step. There's no GCF across here. Next step should be, this is a positive, so my signs both should match. The middle one. 25 is a perfect square. So if it is the last one a perfect square? So if it is, we're going to guess and check that. So that would be a 5x and a 5x, a 2y and a 2y. So I'm going to go ahead and quickly multiply this out. 25x squared minus 10xy minus 10xy. And again, the design of it is you should get double. That's what this means. We should have had double the middle term. And it works. I want to stress that my math lab is not going to write it in the form that I have it right now. They're going to write 5x minus 2y quantity squared. But these are the same answer. Both will be accepted. It doesn't matter which one you use. I tend to, a lot of times, use the top one because it will help us with the next chapter. So looking at number 6, again, posit it anytime you need to. This first one is a perfect square. The last one's a perfect square. But there was, again, no GCF in the beginning, and they were both positive. So when I see that, can only be 1 and 1. There's no other choices. And the number 36 is a perfect square. So we're going to try 6n squared. That throws a lot of people off being a higher exponent, but if you half it, that's what you try. So we're going to multiply this out. Gives me 36n to the fourth plus 6n squared plus 6n squared, which again should have been double the middle term. So you can either type it as two separate parentheses or you can type it in as a quantity squared. Either one is acceptable.